The followers of the apocalypse are a really interesting group, aren't they? Filled with colorful characters, doctors, and people trying to do the right thing. But I have a sneaking suspicion that they are in fact socialists. That's what we're going to be looking at on today's Gonzo Philosophy. My name is Dr. Luke Zaffer, and I'm going to look at one of the most misunderstood things in all of philosophy. But wait, you say, socialism is bad because socialism means Soviets? Or communism? Or something? Of all the concepts that people don't understand, socialism really tops the list. Right-wingers have made socialism a dirty word in an incredibly bad faith way. They don't understand it, and they use popular anti-communist sentiment to conflate things and just confuse the issues. But I'm going to make socialism as an idea as simple as possible for everyone, and then you can draw your own conclusions. But before I can explain socialism, I'm going to need to explain the means of production. I'm going to need a little help for this.
Hey, comrades. We live in such beautiful society where many things are possible, and we can create magnificent works. But to make such marvelous things, we must have a way to make such things. This is what they call the means of production. To make good health, we must have hospital. To make steel, to make buildings, we must have factory. A thirsty population, we must have clean water. To make beautiful New Vegas casinos, we must have electricity. With inglorious Soviet...
I can't hold up. I'm so dumb. I mean, if we're going to be socialists, the public needs to own or regulate the means of production. That's the important thing here, guys. In New Vegas, this means that the public owns or controls or regulates the Hoover Dam, the farms, the solar power plant, and the medical services. Julie Farkas here leads a group of well-intentioned doctors, traders, scientists, philosophers, and intellectuals in restoring knowledge to the wasteland.
The followers of the apocalypse aren't just interested in research. We care for our fellow man and do everything we can to help humanity. Here in Freeside, we provide food and medical services for those in need. We also have organized reconstruction efforts.
Caesar doesn't care about anyone other than himself. He just cares about his stupid little empire. The NCR is too fragmented and too large to meaningfully care on a large scale. And Mr. House, libertarians don't. If they did care more, then they would probably spend a little bit more time understanding what socialism was and how that benefits them personally. Socialism isn't a complete form of government, though. It's a political and economic theory, which means you need to combine it with a government type. I have to admit something. I had a itty-bitty live omission back when I talked about fascism. Yeah, I left out an important detail. You see, certain types of fascism, like Caesar's Legion, they were socialists. I deliberately left that out. The government controlled the means of production there. The most famous fascists in history, the Nazis, were also known as the National Socialist Workers' Party. Socialism on its own won't necessarily bring about good outcomes. You combine socialism with democracy, and you'll get a state that strives for equality and achieves it, at least in part. You combine socialism with nationalism, and you'll get a slew of problems, most likely a racist wartime society. It's like pizza. Ham can be good on pizza, ham and cheese makes for a good pizza, but ham and pineapple, that belongs in the garbage. The problem was never socialism at all, it was fascism. Now, I want to be really clear about three things. One is that socialism is about public control of the means of production. We, the people, make decisions about the most fundamental aspects of society because we believe that the public should have a say in how they run. They affect everyone. A lot of the time when we're talking about socialism as well, we're talking about socialized policy. So you could have socialized schooling systems where there are public schools, where there are public hospitals, where you have government subsidies for things. We're not talking about a complete holistic system. We're talking about individual aspects and portfolios in society.
Socialism, secondly, is not meant to control all industries. It can work in tandem with capitalism. Government does not control all businesses or enterprises. That's either fascism or communism. We can have socialism and private businesses like casinos and brothels and Sunset Sarsaparilla and Taco Bell. Thirdly, democratic control of roads and schools and hospitals. They're all essential for creating a baseline of equality. And businesses have no interest in creating equality. They're interested in making money. Just look at Mr. House. He has a functioning nuclear reactor and a colossal manufacturing plant, and what does he do with it? Make an army of superpowered fighting robots. Okay, that's pretty awesome. But really, that's just Mr. House that's awesome. Everyone else just gets a raw deal. Imagine the good that the followers of the apocalypse, with their civic-mindedness, could do with a city's worth of power and an automated factory. And they have the goodwill out there already. They have the support of the kings, who want to be a force of good, and basically a school in themselves. And even the local brothel is willing to help out with the chemicals needed. It's a good start. If the people control the means of production, they can make something that's good for everyone, and not just the rich. So that's the gist of socialism. But perhaps you think that socialism is still bunk. I want to leave you with this question. Do you think that any of these would be better off in private hands? Tell me which ones and why in the comments. Thanks for listening.